Coming up tonight on Primetime Local News, Brett Kissel joins us ahead of his upcoming tour. Plus, Lloydminster greenlit changes to the fire services bylaw. And this week's edition of What's Happening.
Primetime Local News, serving the Lakeland and Midwest regions.
Lloydminster has finalized changes to the city's fire services bylaw. Slight revisions were made since the first reading of the bylaw in June of this year. The change revolves around the fire surcharge for developments.
And percentage-wise of the building permit rather than the value of the building itself. So the fire services takes a small portion of the building fee when there's a permit pulled, but that's not based on it's the value of the permit, not on the project. So that was the big difference.
Overall, the focus of the fire services team for Lloydminster is educating residents.
Really, the intention is, and as it talked about, we like to have education first before a penalty is issued. But if someone continuously costs the taxpayers of the city of Lloydminster money to have the fire service arrive to a false alarm because they won't fail to maintain their monitoring system properly, or they continuously have backyard fires that are put risk to their neighbors and others, is something that we have that ability through the bylaw, through the fire department and bylaw services to enforce those fines on people.
Now it's time for us to take a look at our upcoming community events in our weekly edition of What's Happening.
Coming up tomorrow night, it is V-Town Oktoberfest. It's taking place at the Elks Hall in Vermilion, and you are invited out for an evening that is going to be authentically German. They've got some great live music. Three different bands will be performing, plus an opportunity for you to enjoy some delicious food, including bratwurst. There's going to be beverages available as well. A great evening out coming up tomorrow night, a great way to enjoy the evening together with some friends. For all the details and to get your tickets now, you can go online. VTownOktoberfest.ca. The Vic Juba Community Theatre is going to have so many great live experiences this month, and a couple of them are coming up right away. This Sunday night, you've got a chance to see Rumours. It is the ultimate Fleetwood Mac tribute show. They're going to take you back to the late 70s, and you can relive the rock and roll magic with Rumours. And at the Vic Juba Community Theatre, coming up next Friday, October the 11th, George Canyon is taking to the stage. He's a Juno Award winner, a CCMA Award winner. He's got an amazing voice. He shares some great stories, and it's just going to be such a fun night out. Plus, he has so many hits like Good Day to Ride, Somebody Wrote Love, and so many more. If you want to get your tickets for these shows, get all the details, head online right now, victubatheatre.ca. And the Legacy Centre is going to be the site for Lloydminster Reads. It's being presented by the Arts Without Borders Festival, and it's coming up this Wednesday night, October the 9th. Saskatchewan author Joanne Jackson, she's going to be here discussing a couple of her books, so you can enjoy that discussion, some great desserts, and more. For all the details, head online to artswithoutborders.ca. Well, whatever you choose to do this weekend, we hope you stay safe and stay healthy.
What's Happening is brought to you by Northern Factory Workwear, Circle Drive East, Saskatoon, and Highway 17 South, Lloydminster.
I'm joined now by Thomas Wildman, and we're going to talk a little bit about the weather here. Judging by the sweater you've gone on, it seems to be a little bit chillier out here today.
Yeah, it was not the most pleasant day. You know, lots of wind, which we've been seeing throughout the day. And then, yeah, we were, especially early in the morning, we were down to as low as 5 degrees out. So that real cold weather just did feel was very much around. And we're going to see that a little bit in the weekend. It will warm up a bit, as I think next week we're going to see a little bit of nicer temperatures, especially after Thanksgiving coming up this weekend. But yeah, as you can see here, we had the high of 13 for today and a low of 3. Now, we're usually about there at this point in time in the year, so we're about on schedule for these cold temperatures coming, which is good and bad. It's slightly unfortunate that the cold is here now, especially considered last year where we weren't having snow until all the way into January, but then, of course, the cold weather came right away after that. So it all makes up for itself in the end, but yeah, very similar temperatures to what we're supposed to be having here today. High of 13, low of 3. 13 and 1 is the usual normal. Currently, it's 14 degrees at the Lloydminster Airport, and the wind isn't making too much of an effect right now. I think it's cooled off a little bit, but that southeast 32-kilometer wind is still going to be affecting you, especially if you're not in any sun right now, and it will be much more effective as the night goes on here in Lloydminster. Elsewhere, North Battleford is sitting at 17. They have lots of clouds right now and are looking quite nice for the rest of this evening, and just a nice day out in Saskatchewan. And then Cold Lakes, very similar to us, even a little chillier at a high, currently sitting at 12 degrees. They've got an east 22-kilometer wind hitting them right now. Taking a look at the current temperatures across the region, Lloydminster, as mentioned, at that 14, Cold Lake at 14 right now, Marwain at 14, we got Wainwright and Provost also at 14, and then 11 out in Edmonton and Lac La Biche. Bonnyville nice and warm up to 15 today, and then St. Paul and Vegreville and Vermilion all at 13 degrees. On the Saskatchewan side, we're seeing very similar temperatures. St. Walburg and Maidstone both at 14, 15 in North Battleford now, 17 in Macklin, a 14 up in Green Lake as well, and Pearson at 15, and then Isle of Cross cooler at 10 degrees with Meadow Lake sitting at 13 degrees. Tonight's forecast in North Battleford is a low of 5 degrees. They're going to see increasing clouds, and then it's becoming very windy late with an occasional rain and drizzle, a 60% chance of that precipitation coming down, and so you're definitely probably going to see at least a little bit of moisture out in North Battleford and area. In Cold Lake, though, they are going to see an evening shower in some places, so you might miss it depending on where you are in Cold Lake or in the surrounding area. Otherwise, it'll be cloudy, a 40% chance of that precipitation, a low of 3 degrees. And here in Lloydminster, a low of 3, very similar to Cold Lake, but it's going to be cloudy with some increasing, it's going to get increasingly windy, and with a passing shower later there, 80% chance of precipitation, so we're going to be seeing some moisture here in Lloydminster as well. But now a quick look at our three-day forecast for tomorrow. It's going to be windy and a high of 9, and then it's going to warm up on Thanksgiving Sunday, warmer, but it will still be breezy at 16, and on Monday it'll be partly sunny and mild, a high of 18 degrees. But that will do it for our first look at the weather forecast. I will be back later with an extended look at the weather forecast. But for now, we will have some more news headlines.
Canadian country music artist Brett Kissel is stopping in Lloydminster as part of his The Side You've Never Seen tour on December 2nd. I got the chance to sit down with him to talk about the upcoming tour. I'm joined today by country music star Brett Kissel. And Brett, you have a new tour coming out here, an acoustic tour, which is a little bit different than maybe your usual kind of shows. Why don't you tell me about what kind of made you want to do an acoustic tour?
Well, you know what? I've been pretty lucky to travel across Canada many times over the past decade plus, every province, every territory. And during the set, with the full band, I give them a break and I play a couple tunes acoustically. And then I watched Garth Brooks play in Vegas, and watching him play in Vegas was really inspiring. It was just him and his guitar. And I thought to myself the entire night, oh my God, like I would love to do something an entire evening just like that. And so maybe I didn't have the guts to do it before, but I've got the courage to do it now. And I'm really, really excited to present The Side You've Never Seen tour to all of my fans across Canada to come out and experience something that, well, they would have never experienced with me before.
Your shows are usually pretty high energy, and this is going to be a bit of a change of pace from that. How do you think you're going to adapt your shows to maybe make up for there not being, you know, as high energy as there would be on one of your other tours?
Well, I think the biggest thing is making sure that the audience understands that this is all about the song. This is all about the story. This is all about the lyrics, and it's all about connection. When you're playing a high energy set, I'm there to throw a party. And that's a wonderful thing that I've been able to do for a long time. There will be elements of my set that will be party. Don't get me wrong. I've written all these songs, so of course I'm going to play them. And it's going to have a very, very special meaning. But if you've ever been to or heard of the Bluebird Cafe in Nashville, it's an amazing songwriter's spot where everybody gets to share the story behind the songs that people love so much. So that's exactly what I want to do on the Side You've Never Seen tour, and peel back all of these different layers to explain that it's not just about the energy, it's actually about the emotion behind the song.
Brett, you kind of grew up around this area. So what's kind of special about, you know, maybe coming back here on your tour stops and playing, you know, in Lloyd here, you know, surrounding area, kind of where you're from?
Well, I'm a small town guy. I'm very proud of that. I grew up in St. Paul on a cattle ranch, you know, between St. Paul and Lloydminster, and played hockey in Lloyd and would go and watch the Chucks every year. And so for me, it's really great and very important to come back to communities that were a big part of my upbringing. When I was a little kid, I would play at the Vic-Juba. When I was a little kid, I would play in Vermilion and Neilburg, Saskatchewan. Every winter, I still go up to Paradise Hill, Saskatchewan to go deer hunting at Buck Paradise. I love that area, so it's important for me to always, if I can, always come back to the small towns because I'm a small town guy.
Awesome. And do you have any new projects on the go? Have you been working on some new songs, maybe a new album?
In a couple of days, I'm heading back down to Nashville to do more recording. And so I'm looking forward to that. I'm always writing new songs. And whenever a creative burst hits me, it's not too long after that I'll find studio time to go and bring these songs to life. So Let Your Horses Run was the first single, you know, that is going to come off this new record. Now we've released a song called Another One, and I'm really proud of both of those songs. Another One is going for, ads at country radio tomorrow. So I'm really excited that, people are going to get a chance to hear these two new songs, the acoustic versions of them on tour, and then a whole pile of new music that I've been writing over the past couple of months that, quite frankly, I'm going to try out on our crowds across Canada. And if they like them, it's going to go on the record. If you don't like them, well, I'll put it on the junk pile.
Awesome. Yeah, it seems like you're a very creative guy. You're always coming out with some new music. Do you have any advice for maybe aspiring songwriters and musicians that are maybe trying to get to where you're at?
You know, there's a lot of different pieces of advice, and I think there's a lot of noise out there, especially on TikTok and Instagram, where everybody's trying to be an expert. The biggest thing is to find your own lane and to understand that you have a unique sense and a unique opportunity to be somebody different, and don't try to be somebody that you're not, because there already is a Morgan Wallen, or there already is a Carrie Underwood. There already was a George Strait. So I think it's really important to find your own lane and then work really hard and be unapologetic about it, because someone being genuine and somebody being authentic is rare these days, but it's very attractive. And I believe fans are very attracted to those who are very authentic.
Now, of course, Brett, most people that know you're a big Oilers fan. They've seen you do the American National Anthem at a few games, and it's always cool to see that, you know, when somebody's representing their team. What are your Oilers predictions for this year?
Evan Bouchard will be up for the Norris. Stuart Skinner will be up for the Vezina. Leon Draisaitl is going to win the Conn Smythe. And Connor McDavid is going to hoist the Stanley Cup at center ice in June at Rogers Place in front of 19,000 screaming fans and one crying Brett Kissel. I will be crying my eyes out in pure joy and pure happiness to watch that happen.
Awesome. Those are some predictions I can definitely get behind as a fellow Oilers fan. Now, where can people go to buy your tickets?
Very simple. Just go to brettkissel.com and make sure you guys follow me on social media, all of the platforms, so that I can give you more details on VIP packages and opportunities to upgrade your experience on the side you've never seen tour. brettkissel.com has all the details.
Well, thanks, Brett, for your time. Everybody make sure to check out Brett Kissel on his new acoustic tour on December 2nd at the Vic-Juba Theater.
You betcha. Thanks a lot, Lane. Have a good day.
The Border City Card Show will once again be coming to Lloydminster on October 19th at the Gold Horse Casino. Our Thomas Wildman has more on the Collector's event.
Today I'm joined by Chris Brinklow, the organizer of the Border City Card Show, and he's here today to tell us a little bit about this semi-annual event. And so thank you so much for joining me today, Chris.
Thanks a lot for having me, Thomas. It's great to have this event again. We actually have it twice a year. First one is usually in March, and then the next one is in October. And then we do that because it kind of hits different points in the hobby collecting, especially in the hobby, hockey part of the hobby, where we have Series 1 coming out in October, and that's kind of the big upper deck mainstay, I guess, that's been around since the 90s, early 90s. And then back in March, where the last part of the series comes out. And so that's kind of what the hockey hobby kind of sits around. But that's not all that this show is about. There's going to be Magic the Gathering. There's a tournament that's put on by Border City Games. And that's going to be fantastic. A lot of fun for them. That's going to be taking place on the stage at the casino. And then also there's Pokemon. There's other, you know, sports and interests as far as the hobby collecting goes.
And where did the idea to host a local event like this come from?
So I have to be honest, I don't know a lot about Magic the Gathering and Pokemon. I mean, I know some of it, but I don't know a lot about the value and what's all a part of it. But that's why we have folks like our friends at Border City Games, who they have games on a nightly basis. They have the best collection in town. So they are the ones that really can speak towards everything that related. For myself, I've been a card collector since the early 80s. My brother was a card collector since the early 70s. So he had some of the old Montreal Canadian rookies like Guy Lafleur and Ken Dryden. So when I saw him with his old OPG collection, obviously that spurred me on to collect cards when I was a kid. And as a kid, you don't really take very much care of it. I wish I did, because I would have been not living in this house. I would have had a much better mansion, I'm sure, by now if I would have paid more attention as a child. But that's one thing that this hobby does bring out, is your inner child. And it's just a lot of fun to collect. It's a fun hobby. Sometimes it does get costly. Depends on what player you're chasing. But, you know, it's something that we've seen grow, especially over COVID. A lot of people had time on their hands, and so they started collecting. And, you know, 2020, you know, when the series of 1920 was out, that really caught fire, and then it's just growing. And then, you know, Connor Bedard's rookie card came out this last year, and that just really injected a sense of, you know, here's an all-star player. People are chasing this card. It's still going for $450 fresh out of a pack. So it's one of those things where this hobby is continuously growing. We have a fresh crop of new rookies coming out this year. The release for Upper Deck Series 1 is next week Friday, which I believe is, or no, not even next week Friday. It's like 2 days before the show. So we're going to have fresh boxes at the show for sure. But it's just really been growing, and we've seen collectors who used to be in it in the 90s come back and be like, hey, you know what? I kind of missed this. I got out of it for a while, but now we're back. And that's kind of my story. But my friend Braden, who also co-manages this event with me, he's a great guy to be working with, and he also has a nice collection. We collect different, but same. And he's more, does some baseball and football. But yeah, it's fun to meet everybody and see what they got in their collection and in their stock and what they're willing to move for. Also, the timing of this event is amazing, because it's right before Christmas, 2 months before Christmas. So it's a good time to start Christmas shopping if you have a hobby collector in your family. And it's just, it's also for good cause.
And finally, Chris, you mentioned that you guys are raising money for a great cause. What is that cause, and where is this event going to be taking place, and when?
It is for a cause. We are raising money for Lloydminster's United Way, and they have a couple of projects going on with helping some people that maybe are in need for education and in need for help with the family. So the United Way certainly covers a lot of areas in our community, and whether we're just raising a few hundred bucks or whatever it is, every little bit helps. And so proceeds of the door, which is $5, that goes towards the United Way. And also, we're having a special guest. I didn't have to reach too far to find an NHL alumni right here in our town, Mr. Jeff Wawitka, our Bobcats coach. He has gladly agreed to come out and sign some autographs. Jeff was originally drafted, I believe, by the Oilers, and then traded to St. Louis in a Chris Pronger deal. and then made his NHL debut in St. Louis and played with the Blues for a bit. Didn't have a long NHL career. I mean, at his age, Jeff could still be playing. But so we're glad to have Jeff come out. He'll be there from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. And it's just going to be a great show. We have a raffle. Proceeds of the raffle are also going to United Way. So it's going to be a fantastic time at the casino October 19th, running from 11 a.m. till 5 p.m. And we encourage everybody, whether you're new to the hobby, been around the hobby for a long time, or you found some stuff in your basement and you want to see what it's worth, PSA will be there accepting submissions. And that's the best grading company there is in the market. So we have companies and groups from Edmonton, Froggers, and Capital City Sports Cards. So we have collectors from everywhere that are coming here and taking part in this show.
Thank you so much for all the information today, Chris, and we look forward to yet another great Border City Card Show.
Awesome. Thanks a lot.
Coming up after the break, Thomas Wildman will give us a wild look at your weather.
Welcome back. We're going to take a quick look at our future radar here. As you can see, there are some massive systems forming down south in Alberta, which will then give way here just to a system that's going to be coming through Saskatchewan. We are going to see a little bit of that, especially in Lloydminster overnight tonight. It's just not getting quite up there, but there is going to be a small system kind of moving through there into Lloydminster. But yeah, you can see that we're going to see big rain across all of Saskatchewan here with how big those systems are and the large amount of yellow and red severe rain. Hopefully that is not snow coming down in any of those major areas there. Taking a look now at current temperatures across the central region, Lloydminster and Cold Lake at 14, as is Red Deer and Rocky Mountain House. And then Whitecourt and Jasper sitting a little cooler today at 6 degrees, Athabasca at 10, Edmonton at 11, and Edson sitting at 9. On the Saskatchewan side, we've got North Battleford and Prince Albert and Melfort all at 15 degrees, Saskatoon a little warmer at 17, and Meadow Lake sitting at 13 degrees. Down south in Saskatchewan, 21 in Swift Current, 20 in Kindersley and Regina, a little bit cooler in Yorkton at 15 degrees today, Estevan at 22, and Moose Jaw at 23. On the south side of Alberta, we've got Medicine Hat at 25 degrees, Lethbridge at 23, Calgary at 20, Coronation at 14, and Banff cool at 5 degrees right now. Taking a look at tomorrow's forecast here in Lloydminster, we're going to have showers at 6 a.m. as mentioned earlier in the future radar. 4 degrees in the morning there when those showers hit. Noon, we're only going to be up to 5 degrees and some intermittent clouds there as well. That will continue to 6 p.m., a high of 8 degrees, and at midnight, it'll cool down back to a high of 3 degrees. We'll be mostly clear by then, though. Taking a look at North Battleford, they're going to be similar to us, to our very windy, low clouds, and it is going to be quite a bit cooler, a high of 11 for them. 25% chance of precipitation, might be a little drizzle there. And taking a look at Cold Lake, they're going to have a high of 8 degrees. It is going to be breezy in the morning. Otherwise, we will see a lot of low clouds early, so there may be some visibility issues on your morning commutes with those low clouds and fog, and it will be cooler. 19% chance precipitation will likely not be anything too major. Taking a look at the travel forecast across the rest of the Lakeland region here, Meadow Lake is going to be a high of 9 degrees with a few morning showers. We're going to see showers also in Isle of Cross. And then Bonnyville and is going to be similar to Cold Lake tomorrow. Provost, a high of 11. And then Paradise Hill, a low of 9. Also going to be seeing those low clouds. And taking a look a little further away, still plenty windy pretty much across the board. Calgary is going to be a little bit sunnier, though, and a bit cooler, though, a high of 15 for them. But then in between 11 and 10 and 9 there for Miriam Pearson, Unity, and Wainwright. And now taking a look at the 7-day forecast. After Monday, it is going to continue to warm up to 21 degrees, nice and warm there once again. There is going to be a little bit of a mix of sun cloud that'll continue into next Wednesday, high of 18, mostly sunny and mild. Thursday, it's going to cool off again down there, and that will continue into next Friday at a high of 16 degrees. But some good to see there next week, but also some cool temperatures sticking around here.
Yeah, for sure. Definitely looks like, yeah, this is kind of the coolest it's going to be for a little bit. Then it's going to warm up once again. There's some wind tomorrow, yeah.
Yeah, for sure. Definitely going to be windy tomorrow, but hopefully we'll be able to keep some warm weather for a little bit longer.
Well, that's all the time we have today for Primetime Local News. Thanks for watching.